born in light.
Raised in darkness.
Wild heart for eternity.
Welcome everyone to Wildheart Session 3. Our adventurers have somehow been transferred into a forest that seems to be hard to get through. Their Pathfinder seems to be either lost or there's something very strange going on here.
I know precisely where we are.
Of course.
We're not where we're supposed to be. That's precisely where we're at.
And where we just left off the last session was in front of a cave where just hundreds and hundreds of copper coins has been spilled on the ground everywhere. And we are just about to explore the inside of this cave.
Really? Because I thought we were about to set off some sort of nasty trap.
One does not exclude the other.
Yeah.
This is very true.
Too many notes.
So, as I recall, we had Joel's character taking a peek inside while the others were staying outside. Is that correct?
That's correct. I'm the sacrificial lamb.
Vader wants to be within screaming distance so that if he ejaculates some kind of cry of death and pain, he can relay that to everybody.
Mm-hmm. What did he say? He said, Well,
that doesn't sound good.
That was one or four R's.
I don't know. Could you repeat that? Definitely four.
Right.
It's never good when the rogue screams.
So, Aeodan sneaks up to the cave, peeks inside, and you see large stalactites that are clinging to the ceiling of a huge cave room. An acrid stench of sulfur meets you when you leave the warm air outside the cave and step into the darkness. Engulfed almost entirely of darkness and daylight, cut like sharp knives into the darkness, revealing blackened walls and copper coins that are scattered across the floor. A huge skeleton twists unnaturally on the ground and makes you gasp and marvel at its size. A dragon skull as big as a small house extends to the light as if it were its only chance to remember its former power. You look at its huge skeleton and shudder at the thought of what this dragon beast could once achieve at its power and its power devastate. You see monstrous ribs looking up into the darkness and makes the bones to look like a shipwreck whose fate was sealed long ago.
Ooh.
Picture.
That is spooky.
There's bones in here. And by God, it smells like Dre was in here for a weekend.
No, this is the wrong cave.
That's what you got to.
No, I tell you, wrong cave. Wasn't in the forest.
So I take it it's probably not lit beyond the entrance?
No, there are a couple of beams of daylight striking in here and there, but mainly it is completely dark.
Well, I don't know what this will really accomplish for us. It definitely won't get us out of the forest.
Well, what harm could there be? I mean, there may be. Can anyone hear, slight trickling? Slight trickling water. In there? Anywhere?
What is farther in? I mean, it's dead, whatever's in there.
Adam takes a little glowing stone and sets it free to float above his head.
All right.
Basically, it's continual flame on a dead ion stone.
Gotcha.
Bane kicks some of the copper and... You think this was some kind of offering?
Well,
could be. I don't know. You're the religious one. Would this be an offering?
I wouldn't pick it up. Generally, when you find money around dead things, you shouldn't pick it up.
That's not what you said in that one place.
That was different. He had just died.
Uh-huh.
You had killed him.
You never complain. Never complain when it comes from me.
Well, the dragon didn't try to rob us. Okay?
Well, I'm going to make a perception roll for any kind of traps or anything here around the entrance.
All right.
18.
You do not seem to find any type of traps.
So I assume there's nothing else for us. Everything leads to here, and we have no way out of the forest. We might as well continue to look, yes?
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Hey, the things I get into with you guys.
Life would be dull if you didn't.
Thirteen on a stealth roll. I'm gonna start slowly picking my way forward.
All right.
We'll move 15 feet here.
The cave does seem to be completely empty, apart from the skeleton and the hundreds and hundreds of copper coins. It is a large cave and it just keeps going.
I'm going to make a survival roll for tracking and see if there's any footprints in the entry of the cave. 16.
You find that there have been boots walking around here, but not for perhaps months, maybe half a year even. But it is clear that it is one pair of tracks.
Going in or going out?
Both.
Hmm. Well, someone entered here at some point, and they managed to make their way back. I'm assuming it's the same pair of footprints going in and out?
Yes, multiple times.
Well, somebody has been here a few times. See these footprints here and here? And see how they come back in and go out there again?
Oh.
I'm wondering if all these copper coins are not the leavings of them for more valuable items.
Definitely worth investigating, eh, Bernard?
I would say so, perhaps, yes.
I'm going to try and follow the footprints the same path, because obviously if they didn't set off a trap going in, unless they left something nasty behind for anybody following, I think we should be relatively safe.
Sure,
famous last words.
What's the worst thing that could happen?
Death, dismemberment.
Death and dismemberment?
Total party kill. Well, this was a short-lived series.
Yeah. Or worse yet, we lose loot. No.
You don't even say those words.
Are you going to stay out there with that damnable horse?
He's not a horse.
It's he a horse like with a antlers.
Hey. Okay,
he does not mean it. You are not a horse.
You better watch it. Last time I called him horse, he was not happy.
Yes, well, he looks like he belongs on the dinner plate.
I don't know. He's kind of tough.
There we go.
So, keep going up. Bloop, bloop.
Further in we go.
Do you want to make random rolls for me for traps, or do you want me to do that?
You can make a perception check.
Twenty-four, unless it's traps, and then it's 26.
You believe that you heard a rock fall, like as if it was moved further up.
You'll gesture for them to hold still and try to listen more intently. I'm assuming I don't hear anything again, though. It probably doesn't repeat, right?
No.
Okay. Gonna come over by the bones. I'll check for traps along the way if it's not following the footprints. For traps, we're looking at 15.
There don't be any traps. Just more coins.
All copper?
More copper.
Well, there's lots of copper.
Yeah, you collect them all up, you might get a few gold.
Uh-huh.
By the way, Bernard, are we going to take any of these bones with us? You know how much dragon bones would sell for?
I'm up here inside the skull. You said it's as big as a house?
That's a small house.
Yep, I'm going to look inside it.
My issue, Bane, is how would we get the bones out?
Well, we can only take the little ones, you know. Like the tailbone, maybe he have ear bone, you know. I'm sure there's some kind of use. I bet if we found some hocusy-focusy person, they could use it for components in their spooky boos.
Well, Bernard, and he, like, slaps your... I suppose he's, like, this tall, so, like, the front of your thigh with the back of his hand. The teeth!
The teeth!
Aiden just rolls his eyes where they can't see it.
The dragon does not have any teeth. But the skull is empty.
Somebody already took his teeth! Can you believe it?
Bollocks.
Does he have any horns?
No horns.
No horns, no teeth. It looks like he's been picked clean over. No claws, I'm assuming, too?
There are claws.
I'll take it.
Monstrously big are those?
Well, you have the picture, so they are about the size of half the size of a human.
We could fit some of those, you think? Yeah?
We could take a couple.
Yeah.
I'm going to step beyond and let them pick around the bones. I'm assuming I'm the only one with a light lit.
I can see in the dark. I don't know what Bane.
I know you can.
I have regular vision unless I transform to get some. Yeah, Bane's willing to pick up a couple claws, one under each arm, and start taking it out to the wagon.
I'm going to keep it there while he's messing with the bones.
So as we are picking around the bones, a sudden echo, a clash, fills the cave entrance.
Fool of a Took! Next time, throw yourself in. Oh, wait. Wrong movie.
Who are you? Go away!
Who are you?
Go away, I tell you! This is my cave! Go away! Now! Leave!
We would, but we can't.
Show you can! The entrance is open! Just go!
The forest brought us here! He hasn't stopped yanking on some of the... gauze.
Will you stop that?
What? Why?
Please,
Dragon Knuckle. Please,
just leave. Please.
Okay, we'll leave. We'll leave with the claws. Hold on.
Yes. Take it. Leave, please.
See, not stealing now. We have permission.
We would have taken them anyways.
Lee doesn't know that. Shut up.
It's not like the dragon is using them anymore.
Who are you, friend?
No one. This is my cave. You can leave.
Well, no one of the cave with a voice. We are kind of stuck here. We cannot find our way out of the woods.
No one can. So what? Leave, please.
Hey, do you have any special water in here? I heard this story.
There's no water here.
Well, we need to find a different cave.
Would you like some water?
No.
Or maybe food, perhaps?
No.
I think perhaps he is lying.
We have sweet things and spices.
I need none of that.
Oh, not even for great prices too, right? That's pitch, yes? Great yes. prices. Oh, great prices.
You can leave it. Just take the copper. How much you whatever you need.
Copper? She jerks off one of the knuckles, starts walking with the claw towards the exit.
I mean, dragon knuckle bones, they're worth a lot of money. Probably could make some sort of trade.
I'm sure they're good Hellhound chew toys.
Hey, why trade? He gave us, yeah? No
well,
trade.
I mean, it's only trade must be fair. This man, this gentleman must have compensation, eh?
You and your gods. He gave.
Do you know of any way out of the woods?
Perhaps.
And?
If you leave, you promise to leave.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, okay.
I didn't hear it.
I promise to leave this cave.
And not come back.
Oh, geez, you just got stipulation, don't you? Yes, and not come back.
You too.
Do it.
Unless you have the means of leaving this woods buried in there.
I want your word that you will leave and not come back.
Bane gets back from taking her knuckle out. What am I promising? What?
Just tell him. Not just tell him we're not going to come back.
We're not going to come back? We're not! What about the rest of the bones?
I'm sure there are other caves with other dead dragons.
What? We have been adventuring for at least 3 years and not seen any other caves with any other dragons.
This is where we're going to take the rest of these knuckle bones and we're going to leave the crazy old man alone.
Oh, the rest of them come now.
This will be trade for his information.
Oh, well, he gave. Fine. Okay, no come back unless the forest makes us. Then we don't really have choice, do we?
All right. Well, there is supposedly one way to get out. You must know the forest secrets. I happen to know one of them.
We don't even know what forest we're in.
And you hear the echoing laughter throughout the cave.
Yes, we thought it was funny, too. Ha ha!
Yes, it was funny when we broke camp last night and woke up in the middle of nowhere.
Well, trespassers, I can gladly inform you, you are inside of Wildheart.
Oh, great.
Oh, great! Is where place, I told you, we'd probably be where place was that had Fountain of Youth. Do you know where Fountain of Youth is?
There's no Fountain of Youth.
I know how to get out, and that is what I promised you for you to leave. Me, alone, here, in my cave.
We'll give you stuff for Fountain of Youth, secret, you know it.
No!
No, you don't know it, or no, you not give it.
I will tell you how to get out. I will share my secret, and then you will leave and not come back. And that will be the end of it.
I'm going to use some of these bones as cover. I'm going to leave my light laying on the ground.
All right.
And since I got the bones for cover, I'm going to try and sneak through the rib cage. See if I can see who this is. And well, that is 23 on the stealth roll.
What is your secret? I say distractingly.
I would tell you if you just kept to the subject and not... See? Listen good. My secret that I have... The secret is, did Grunfeed die when he slew the dragon Aimton? No!
That's a more like question than secret.
Yeah, that's not... It's really, I don't understand how that helps me leave.
But...
Say that again, please. So I can actually write this down, like, out of character.
Yeah, so am I.
I'll type it for you.
That's even better. Who names their kid Grumfeed?
I don't know.
It's a horrible name.
Grumfeed? I don't know.
Is it Grumpy?
Grumpy, yeah! From Seven Dwarfs.
What?
You know. Strange fairy tale, grandmother say. You know, listen to your grandmother fairy tales. Shame on you. Listen to grandmother.
Well, I shared my secret and the answer, and I will have you leave now, trespassers. Leave!
But what does that mean?
It's important. That's what it means.
Are you Grinfeard?
No!
Is this the dragon?
Yes.
Then you must be Grinfeard.
No!
Well, you're not dead.
Well, no.
I'm going to attempt another sneak. Duck behind a stalagmite or something.
Do we have to find him to get out?
Is there cover available?
I'm going to reveal you a bit more.
Oh, excuse me. I'm going to continue to go up the dragon's ribcage until I come out the sphincter area. Ooh, that's a good roll. 26.
All right. You can make a perception check.
Come on, big money. 20.
All right. After listening for a multiple, after listening, you hear that the echoes of the voice is coming from this away.
Is there a cave wall in front of me?
Yeah, this is a cave wall. But then there is darkness.
You swore, trespassers! You swore to leave!
I'm going to attempt to crawl over here.
I can't take your your information doesn't make any sense. This is bad trade!
28.
Doesn't have to make sense. I'm telling you, it's important. I even told you where you are. You didn't even know that. How incompetent can you be?
I had my suspicions.
Bane just looks at him and says, yeah, it's incompetent. How much can be?
I got a 28 to get to the
wall. Coming from you, is rich.
Hey, I make money.
Did I give you?
Hey.
He doesn't...
Does that make me less or more intelligent? You give me money.
The person does not seem to notice that you come up closer.
Yes, well, I do not hire you for your intelligence, do I? I hire you for all of this.
That's right. I don't even have to use my intelligence. That's how smart I am.
Do I at least see their form around the bend here?
Well, if you peek, behind the cave wall, I'm going to reveal a bit more here.
I am not going to do that personally. I am going to use a mirror down towards the floor where it's less noticeable. I'll use that around the edge.
So, it is a humanoid shape, larger than a ordinary human. But the scarce light is not giving you much more than that.
But he's around the bend and can't really see much anything.
Well, you see that he peeks out now and then when he's shouting and looking for you, like he was telling you not to pick up the dragon claw, but you still did it.
Fair trade for dragon claw. We made. Deal. All right, you want anything before we go? Like spice, like what else you have, eh?
There's honey left.
Sales pitch. I ate all the maple syrup, but there's other.
I need nothing but peace and quiet and for you to leave.
You don't eat?
There has to be food and water here if he doesn't.
I'm going to pay a mind to these guys to pick up my stone and throw it over here.
You want us to do that?
Yep.
Man, you've got a better arm than I do.
Eh, what? What am I throwing, eh?
A teeny tiny rock is what you're throwing.
Look at this, the glowing rock that...
Glowing rock, okay, throwing the... Am I throwing the rock? Does he want the rock? Do you want the rock?
Shut up. What?
Yeah.
Yes.
We have this stone you may be interested in, yes? Show him, Ben, show him the rock.
I need
We won't come any closer. You look at rock and then throw back if you don't want. He tosses the rock. Do you want to roll or no?
Well, you can make a ranged attack.
You know, against a with a 5 to hit the rock or to hit the grounder.
Five. Well, dripping over bones.
Well,
can I make a X check or something to try and catch that horrible, horrendous throw?
It's only 5 to get to where I'm supposed to be anyway. So there.
Well, there is ranged penalty.
Where am I throwing it to?
Somewhere here.
Right there. So I was right there. Yeah. It is 55 feet. Wow, it's farther than I thought it was. Yeah.
Yeah, it's extreme range, so it's at -8 or some crap like that.
Who put bones here? Who put bones here?
So basically, the stone hits one of the ribs and just falls down here.
Whoops! Sorry! I'll get...
Give us one moment. We will try again.
He clatters. He starts making a bunch of noise, clattering through the bones.
Trespassers!
I should actually light up to here.
One final warning.
All right, I'm getting here. Throw. I'm there. Hold on. Throw and move, and then here. Here it is. There. Throw.
It's not even like a people.
So using the mirror, what the hell is this thing?
Throw it with a one again.
Like a weird God, you suck at throwing.
Oh! I'm
not a thrower.
He's a little half-throw.
Here is rock. See if you want. If not, we leave. Just in case.
Oh, you've done it now.
Done what? You want rock or not?
You shall leave now, or I will clobber you.
Whoa, this is threatening of physical violence.
Oh. So this I'm just sounds more fun.
Keep hidden for the most part.
You look, friend, I do not think you want to be making threats like this, yeah?
I am going to draw my hand axes, though.
All right.
Because murder hobo, of course.
I asked you over and over again to leave my cave.
All right. Are we leaving or staying?
I do not think he has anything we want.
Don't think so. Nothing but bones and copper. I'm getting the last knuckle, though. Part of deal.
Yes. Just leave.
Fine. We'll be back if Forrest makes us come back. Then you think about what we have to do. Because if Forrest won't let us leave, we have no control over such things, you know.
Where did my stone end up?
I hope you have dice. You know, do you play dice? He says, picking up the...
In the last in the dragon novel. Crotch.
go pick up Aiden's rock for him.
Is there anything back there besides him?
It just seems to be more cave.
All right, I'll try and creep silently back out. Nat 20 to the sneak roll. Like the freaking mist.
You're getting all the good rolls for the party right now.
Yeah, and then it'll turn to garbage when combat enters. It'll be awesome.
That's okay. I haven't had the negative ones yet.
Grabbing the knuckle.
All right.
If Forrest makes us come back, where are you being?
If we find a way out, we may come back for you.
Yeah, we'll help you out if you want, maybe. You're nice.
No thanks.
What? You want to stay here?
Just leave!
Yeah. If Forrest makes us come back, make sure have refreshments, yeah? I'm hungry.
You said you had supplies, whatever.
He's always hungry. did Grenfell die when he slew the dragon? I'm done.
No. I believe he answered his own question.
No, he was telling us it's not Grunfeld, correct?
No, he's telling you that he did not die.
The secret is he didn't die, so Grunfeld was still alive after he killed the dragon. Whatever that means. How many dragon bones did we get?
We got a couple of knuckles.
Quads of a dragon.
I carried out at least two.
You managed to get three claws and two knuckles.
Three dragon claws and two knuckles.
He was a half-troll. Kind of looked like that girl you are so fond of.
Really? Maybe they were related. Hey, do you know somebody named Asta?
No!
No!
Are you sure?
Yes!
She is half-troll.
And?
Well, maybe you know her.
Yeah, Bane, that's racist.
She has family. Family from Edge of Wildheart.
Well, I don't. So, leave.
Okay. But maybe you do. We'll find out some other time. Yeah, talk to you later.
No!
Bye.
Okay. That's
such a nice half throw. So, where do we go now?
So you leave the chilly cave and come out into the warm forest.
Grab a couple handfuls of copper as we're leaving.
Well, we definitely know we're in Wildheart, so we should just be able to go south and get out eventually.
You didn't ask him what part of Wildheart. You just asked us where we were.
Was anybody, know their history or folklore?
History? No, I don't know anything about history.
Yeah,
I know stuff about trees and rocks.
I'm going to try knowledge local to see if either of those names, Grenfeld or Imton, is familiar. Just got a 19. That's awesome. So 23 for local.
And 22 for history.
For local, you know that you know that Grunfeld was a renowned dragon hunter of sort. You don't know completely what his title or trade was, but he was hunting dragons.
Okay. And
yeah.
For history, you know that the renowned dragon hunter actually entered Wildheart, but you don't know if he came out or what happened. And you know that the dragon's name was fairly well known, but presumably the dragon was slain at some point, because the dragon was pestering the land a great deal, but of late
there has been no reports.
Does he know how long ago was this?
This is generations ago.
Long enough for the scales to turn to rock, too.
Well, you know, it is Wildheart. Strange stuff happens, you know.
Oh, look at you, the local expert.
Well, I just, you know, it's weird. I know enough about this, the world around me to know you don't go playing around in Wildheart. Unless you're looking for Fountain of Youth, we can do that. Tell you, yeah, we go north, yes? North to get out of Wildheart.
Or find Youth Fountain.
Alright.
So I'm going to add the dragon claws to the fat loot. Mm-hmm.
I added 3 dragon claws and 2 dragon knuckles. I believe that's what I was told.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
I put them under interesting items because they didn't fit the others.
So either south, east, or west works for us. North, not so much.
We can go north.
We are there's giant cliff face in front of us. We cannot go north.
Could go north. Who knows?
We will give you a shovel, and we will come back for you in...
Never.
That's all right. I will stay here with Cave Troll. You want, buddy? See, no even answer now. Good relationship. Only talk when need to. You lost me. Lovable.
All right. So, let's do a survival thing. 26 for heading south.
You manage to find south, and you begin traveling through the harsh terrain. You come upon some really huge trees.
It's a forest. I guess that's not that surprising.
You believe that these are the famous copper trees.
Don't look like these are bigger of copper. Taps
these are these are bigger than the ones near home.
You cannot even see the crown of the tree. It is above the forest canopy.
Can I appraise the tree? Do I...
How much is this copper tree worth now? Are we talking like gold piece worth or
you can sell it for firewood, one bundle at a time. It'll only take you a couple hundred years.
The copper trees are known for their flowers, their copper bloom that are in the crown. Not for the wood itself. It seems... Well,
how would anybody know if you can't see the crown from the ground?
Well,
do you want me to look?
In the copper forest, you can see them. Supposedly.
I've said it before, you can climb your ass up there, and when you fall, I will laugh.
Oh, that is mean. I would not laugh.
And then when you're dead, I will sell your stuff.
Hey, my gold goes back to my family. All the other stuff, no, my amulet goes back to my family. All the other stuff, you know, is yours. But my amulet goes back to family, yeah? Heirloom. Consider it dying wish, he says, looking up the tree.
Stay out of the tree.
Aww. You never let me have any fun, kicks a stone.
And we continue on southward, I guess.
Yeah. Before darkness falls, you actually come upon something after wandering for hours and hours through the ancient forest. And
is it the tavern?
It's not a tavern, unfortunately, but it is a rock. A giant rock suddenly appears out of the forest.
I attack the rock.
A moss-covered steep staircase is leading up to a small opening in the rock. In the opening's shadows, you can glimpse a heavy iron door with sturdy brackets.
Oh, good. Hey, look! More mysterious caves for us to get kicked out of.
Yay!
This is beginning to feel like one of Dre's tavern stories. You know,
see?
The ones where he gets kicked out of every place.
Hey, those are good stories.
God, he tells them a little too often.
That's because they're new stories all the time.
I know. That's right. I can't help that the wenches want to hear them. They ask every time. I say, do you want to hear time about... And they say, oh, yes, yes. Tip them another gold.
Maybe that would make us listen to your stories more. You give me a gold, I'll sit here and listen to your stories.
No, no, no. Your one told me gold is what's worth money. Don't bother with copper. You told me. So I don't bother with copper, I do gold.
That makes no sense.
Ah, that's what I... Gold is so much better looking. Everybody wants gold. Not everybody wants copper.
Well, I told you to give me gold and I'll listen to your stories.
Ah, you listen anyway. You have to. You walk with me.
Are we going up the staircase?
Bane's walking towards the staircase. He's excited.
I gotta leave the wagon and the elk down here then. Wagon right. And the horses and the elk.
You know what? That elk ain't no mountain goat.
Yeah, no. Probably not super going up the stairs.
Climb plus 30 something to climb.
Mm-hmm. Not what he's for. He's for the woods and the prairies.
What's your elk's name?
Phlox.
Phlox? Bane kind of waits till you guys start going. He says, okay, Phlox, listen, man, listen. You watch the bones, okay? Those were good money, man. So you watch the bones, okay? He starts going up this, going towards the stairs with you guys.
Elk kind of looks at you.
He knows guard and defend. Those are tricks he knows.
So he said... He kind of just, It's like, you watch them, man. You watch them. I promise. I will make sure to ask for you to get the lady, yeah? But watch the bones.
And you believe that he winks at you?
Yeah, all right. There we go. He's ready. He's ready to go now.
There's easily been a bug in his eye.
Could have been.
So I look at the bottom step for anything amiss. 26. God, I love having skillful characters.
Well, the staircase is steep and it is covered in moss, so it might be a bit treacherous, but other than that... It seems to be finely carved out of the rock itself. Should be sturdy enough to use.
Well, it looks clear. After you, Bane.
All right. Immortality, here we come. Just thump, thump, thump up the stairs.
And you are in front of the sturdy door.
I look at Bernard. I was seriously thinking he was going to slip and fall on his face.
That's what I thought.
I shrug and then head up the stairs to the door.
You guys never trust me, never trust me. No. What, do I need a knock? You think that's a good idea?
Why don't you let me do my job?
Oh, being sneaky?
Well, then by all means, go ahead and knock.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
I wait halfway down the stairs.
Well, it hurts to knock hard, and if you don't knock hard, there's no sound. But nothing really happens.
No one's answering.
I look at Bernard. I was seriously thinking that, you know, he was going to blow up or something.
Bane's got some kind of plot armor or something. He just walks up and does stuff.
Plot armor. So, I'll go up the rest of the way to the door and examine it too, though I'm fairly certain there's no traps on the door itself. For traps, we're looking at 17-inch.
You don't see any traps, but you do see that there is a rune snake that are hewn out of the mountain just above the door.
Have I seen anything like this?
Well, you have seen some dwarvish carvings that look something like this.
Bernard!
I was going to say, if only we had a dwarf.
Bernard, come look at this thing.
Okay. What am I looking at?
Isn't the serpent a sign of Yorn? Or is it Sylvie?
The serpent for the dwarf, the dwarves are the god Yuck.
Oh, yuck.
Yucky god?
The protector of the sacred texts, as well as the devourer of everything.
Well, that doesn't sound very nice.
As you get up to the door, you see the rune snake, and it is carved with dwarven runes, and it reads, Ronvid Coldhammer, dead and buried, protected and remembered for great deeds. At Bojorn we attest.
So this is a grave, I think.
You would believe that this is a dwarven cairn.
Oh, what?
Well, you're the authority on these things. Do we continue on or do we look in? This may even have one of the clues that we're looking for. That half-troll said we needed 4 clues.
You didn't even get his name, did you? We needed to get his name.
We don't need his name. He's a half-troll in a cave.
Half-troll in a cave, yeah. Hattie, half-troll. Hattie the half-troll.
I still don't understand why you know that one girl's name. She is ugly.
She, don't you talk
that
way.
The ugly one
that
you continually go to town to do.
Do not talk that way about Asta. Asta is beautiful. her lovely personality shines through all physical limitations. You no talk bad about her.
Can you?
She loves me.
Door open.
She has the face of a troll. And that is no bullshit.
I did not say it was. She is beautiful. She is wonderful. You don't talk bad about that stuff. She's nice. Nice to me.
Only because you give her money.
Not just money. Give her a good time, too.
Hold on while I go be sick.
Yeah, can you get this door open or not?
You go do that, well, yeah. You go tell me,
are we safe? Are we going to draw on any crazy dwarven curses?
So this is a tomb, right?
You would believe so, yes.
All right, just don't touch anything. I don't care how shiny. Just don't touch anything.
Nothing?
Yes, hands in your pockets, Bane.
Oh, mean pockets. No.
If it looks shiny or like it belonged to someone else before us, don't touch it.
Which of the
but
three?
But you said we just took bones off dragon.
Yes, that was dead dragon. This is dead dwarf. It's different.
It's a dead dwarf. Dwarf. Dead bandit. Huh? Dead bandit.
Bandit. Different. That dragon was dead in a cave. This dwarf is dead in a tomb.
The bandit was dead on side of road.
Side of road is not tomb.
All three.
Alex, which of the three gods is for protection?
That would... It depends, but protection from combat would be Stormir.
Well, this isn't combat.
Mercy would be Solveig.
Solveig, grant me your mercy on this day, for I may need it. Is the door locked?
It is.
I want to give you touch of... I suppose it would be the same thing as an aid another, but I'll give you touch of good.
Why don't you just let me try my trade here first?
Hey, it's just before a poison roll.
Okay. I must say, though, I am quite good.
Always hedge your bets.
Aiden's all like, hey man, I got this. I got this.
Well, since it is a lock, I believe I get a bonus for that. No, that is for traps only, apparently. Okay. So, 15 plus whatever he just gave me.
Click. And the lock is unlocked.
Okay. Does the door push open or pull open?
You push it open.
Okay. I am going to find a nice sturdy branch of at least 5 feet or more. And I'm going to use it to push the door open.
10-foot pole! Ta-ta.
Yes, I do not have one, but we're in a forest, so I should be able to improvise.
Wait, let me check. No, I didn't. Wait,
besides,
no.
Lanterns are cheaper. Everybody knows this.
Well, the door is very heavy, but you managed to push it open. And inside, you see a straight path that leads into darkness. The walls are covered with runes from gold all the way up to the ceiling. Each rune is filled with silver and little glistenings of silver as the light from the forest outside shines in through the door.
Ooh.
Oh, that is little. Are you sure there is no dwarven ghosts that are going to come and get us for entering where we're not wanted? And why is the damn horse in here?
Because he wanted to come.
Hey, I told you to watch the bones.
The horses will watch bones.
Horses won't watch the bones. They are not like our friend here. He knows how to watch bones, plus he has horns.
I'm actually surprised that the elf would come in here with us. It's really cramped.
Get out of here, you big bastard.
Hey, hey, don't nice. No need to be mean to our friend. He doesn't
know what
he
can do.
So
before we go into the doorway, I'm actually going to check traps from the threshold. 15.
There does not seem to be any traps.
I saw that move. I saw that move game.
Good. I'm an archer. I should be in the back.
I'll set my stone to floating above me, and I'll use a stick in one hand and have one of my axes out in the other, and I'll use the stick to prod the floor in front of me as we go.
All right.
Why are you tapping? Did something happen to your eyes?
Yes, I went blind. Keep following.
Oh, you did that too much. I told you. I warned you about that.
You're the one that gets hairy palms all the time.
Yeah, but mine's not from that.
Yeah, you just pulled the Meldavasta's back hair.
She is smooth back, thank you very much.
Yeah,
I should know.
When you're done.
Fine, silky troll hair.
What, do you doubt? You can see her naked. I'm sure she'll let you.
I'm sure I don't want to.
Yeah, there's that image. You marinate on that for a little while. Talk bad about my Asta.
Bernard, can you read any of this stuff on the walls?
I'm assuming it's in Dwarven.
There are Dwarven rooms, but there are therefore decoration. They don't hold any meaning.
Or troll. I also read troll.
These are not troll.
I would hope not.
Jordy's shining in here.
Do you want to make the trap checks on the sly for me, or am I making them?
Yeah, you can make one.
23.
So, you notice that just before here.
So, move back to there.
There are some anomalies in the walls. To the right and to the left.
Like holes or weaknesses, or what kind of anomalies are we talking?
You find that there are cracks. These are probably movable in some way or another.
But they're not going to collapse the whole roof on top of us if I mess with them?
You don't think so.
Tap, tap, tap.
Nothing seems to happen?
I'm going to take longer to actually study this. see if I can find a mechanism or something. Uh, 27 if it's a trap. Otherwise 25.
It is not a trap. It is in fact a secret passage.
Okay, but how do I open you? I'm gonna mark them with charcoal.
All over the gold and silver runes.
Yeah, I'm not gonna mark on the runes themselves. I'll just mark like a little X in the area so I can find it easy. And then we'll go back up this way.
Right.
I don't want to open doors behind us and then have open doors left behind us. That could be bad. So up yonder way?
Right. You walk up there.
20 for traps.
You see that the end of the hall, this wall here, that it is some sort of a mechanism to activate what could possibly be a trap.
So I'm gonna look for like any holes or any movable bricks or anything like that that might indicate how this works.
The hole just ends at the top?
Yeah.
What's it?
It just ends with a wall.
Hmm.
You believe that you are right now standing on top of a pit trap or something similar.
Step back, guys. Try and find the edge of the pit, and then I try and set it off.
All right.
Actually, I'd like to salvage any parts from it, if I am able.
Well, you know that you need to push the wall, and you know that the floor will disappear somehow and expose what should be a trap.
Can I reach the wall that needs to be pushed using my stout stick? No?
Probably not.
Is the trap the whole width of the hallway, or is it leave like a walkway or anything?
It is. You're basically standing on the edge here. Well, I can't draw there, but at the edge of the staircase, the entire floor will disappear.
Alright, I have these guys tie a rope around me, and then I'm going to do some cool leaning forward stuff on my tiptoes while they provide the counterbalance the other way. And reach with my stick and push the wall, or try and activate the wall in some other means.
Melon.
What's that?
Melon.
Alright.
Speak, friend.
So you push, and the floor opens up completely. There are nowhere to stand, and underneath is a deep fall, more than 10 feet, maybe 15, with long, sharp spears at the bottom.
Well, that could have hurt.
Yeah.
Are there any previous unfortunates at the bottom?
There are not any previous unfortunates at the bottom.
Damn.
Well, at least we know we were the first ones here.
Yes, I hope. I imagine so. Now, could you quit dangling me over the edge of this pit and pull me back?
Yeah. Be quiet. We might catch something.
Or what?
You dangling him down? Do you see anything down there? Nothing?
Stop fishing there's with nothing my scout.
No fun ever. Pulls back up.
All right, back out so that I can mess with these down here.
And it does not mean that we are the first ones here. It only means that there may be someone cleaning this trap out.
Were there any signs of blood or anything?
Well, you didn't see any signs of blood or anything. It seems very clean.
You want to look again? We can look again.
No, you go ahead and you take a look.
I don't think you guys can help me. I am fat.
So there's one of these openings on either side of the hall, or just one?
There's one on each side.
Well, left or right, boys?
Yes.
Left.
Left it is. So I go to the left one, and again, checking it over to make sure that it's not going to kill us in some horribly gruesome fashion. See if I can figure out how to activate it.
You believe that you have to push it?
Well, I've got my stick.
And you push, and you push. 5 feet, 10 feet, and you make an opening.
It just rolls straight back.
Yep.
Did I just hear wind blowing? That's what it sounded like. It sounded like I heard wind blowing. I want to listen and look. Listen for anything that might be moving around, and looking for traps, obviously. 23 on the trap inch.
Seemed empty. There is no sound of anything. There are more runes on the walls. Nothing unusual.
Mirror around the corner?
There is another hallway with statues.
Peek my head around the corner now. I've got statues.
Statues of what?
Are you playing wind blowing? Is that you doing that?
No. Are you paranoid?
Yes. Alright, let's go up this way. That will be a 30 for trappage.
Alright. Well, there are no traps, but each of the statues, which are depicting a dwarf with a shield and a axe, they each have a rune on their chest plates. The same rune.
Bernard!
Yes?
What is this?
How far down here do I have to go to see one of these runes?
Well, stop being such a coward. Get up here.
I have an aversion to arrows in my chest.
Don't worry, it won't be an arrow. It'll probably be an axe.
Yes, I am also allergic to these things.
Well, the rune means guard.
Oh, and, yeah, I'm not touching that.
And you know that the purpose of this rune is to warn other dwarves that there are traps.
Oh, yeah, it's trapped. You remember when I told you hands in your pockets, Ben? Hands in your pockets.
Hearing that stuff about traps, he stuffs his hand in his pockets as best he can.
Alright, let's check the other way first. Go back to there. Same deal. Pushy pushy.
Same deal.
That would be a 21 for trappage.
No traps.
Just more dwarven guardians, huh?
More statues. More runes.
Is it the same rune?
It's the same rune.
Okay, so both of these always are trapped.
Why you dwarves have to trap everything?
Are there any runes on the walls that match the ones on the statues?
No.
What are the statues made out of?
Stone. They seem to have been carved out of the rock.
So they're a part of the wall?
They are.
I do not believe these statues will move themselves.
Hells. Uh, 19 for traps up here.
No traps.
Tap, tap, tap with the floor and the stick and the walls and the statues and...
Nothing seems to happen.
I just thought it would be hilarious if one of those came to life and we all just went like, ah, and ran out of the screen. Nope, 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 nope. All the nopes.
I was so wrong.
Why are we doing this again? Oh yeah, because we went out to this stupid forest.
Well, maybe, you know. And if we get immortal on the way out, that's fine.
I tie the rope around me again. Hey, if I happen to be, you know, gutted or something silly along those ways, could you pull me back out?
Sure, and we'll sell your loot and leave your body to rot. Just like you do for us, right?
That is true, I suppose.
As long as we understand, he says, patting you on the back.
Okay.
I'm sure Bernard will heal you just fine. Maybe.
Anything?
Nope.
Does the dwarves swing at me?
Nope, they seem to be steady as a rock.
Ba-da-boom. Is there anything in them, on them, around them, behind them?
Runes.
Runes. That's your answer to everything. Okay. Go up here, trappage again. 17.
They seem to be just like the others. They have a rune in their chest plate, and they are made of solid rock.
And waiting for the evilness to happen. Okay.
Don't worry about the Deus.
Full commit. Here we go, because we're going to do it anyways. That's a 23 for trappage.
No traps.
Sweet. swear to God, I keep hearing noises from one of you guys.
Oh, I know what you're probably hearing. My office has an air conditioner vent in the ceiling.
Killing me.
Freaking me out, man. It's freaking me out. It's wind, man. Wind.
Okay, over this way.
Looking for audio clues.
22.
No traps.
It is definitely nice.
22 again. Party. Yeah, we never have these. Well, which way, guys?
Well, there's more of this than I thought perhaps there would be.
This is not a tomb, it is a maze.
Does it amaze you?
Alright. Check for traps. Nat 20.
No traps. More rooms, but no traps.
There's an awful lot of checking happening and not a lot of trapping.
Do you want just an average of 22 for me, or 21?
That could work.
Let's do that instead.
You figure that all the gold and silver decorating the walls must have been quite expensive. But there are no traps.
Maybe they are the treasure of the whole place. But we're not really after treasure, anyways.
We aren't? Bernard, does he know what we do?
I am trying to get out to these damnable woods so that we can continue our job and make our livelihood. Oh, and keep my skin attached.
As much as I would like to collect some gold while we are here, we cannot very well spend it if we are trapped in woods forever.
Well, yeah. That's true. I wouldn't see my ladies anymore.
Holy crap, how far does this go on? The sheer mining attempt of this is mind blowing. Oh! There's stairs!
Diggy diggy hole.
I am a dwarf and I'm digging a hole. Freaking Bernard's humming that the entire time we're delving here.
He's subconscious. Every time we go underground, he subconsciously starts to go.
So, especially around these stairs, yeah?
I am Bernard and I'm
digging a hole. Diggy diggy hole. His mother used to sing that to him. My little Bernard, and he digs him a hole. Diggy, diggy hole. Diggy. And it just gets ingrained, you know.
Mm-hmm. From another end of the road.
You imagine that this could be a trap, just like the one you saw before.
Same deal as last time. Tie a rope, lean forward, set it off. If there's any salvageable parts, I take them.
Well, there are spears in the bottom of the pit.
Yeah, I'm not going after those, though.
Other than that, them. It's the same as the other trap.
No bodies?
No bodies.
I ain't got nobody.
Before he pulls him up, he's like, look, Bernard! Gun fishing. See?
That's
See?
Not,
huh?
It's a bad joke.
Oh.
I'm going to put that root that makes you poop in your stew next time.
All right. You come out. It's my night when you do that, you know. Last time, 2 days.
So, back over to this intersection over here.
Mm-hmm.
up this way.
So much the moving.
Bloop.
Oh.
Oh. Oh no, not another one.
Does it never end?
Why did we come here?
These are your ancestors.
What did I do to deserve this?
You were born. Bad born merchant. A dwarf.
This place sucks.
just wait. I didn't
go stairs.
I didn't know what he had planned.
You're standing on the pit now.
I didn't know if there was more to the hallway or not. Same deal?
Again, this is one of the pits.
Yep, set it off same way as before. Nothing inside?
Nothing inside.
Flames shoot out from the bottom and you're roasted.
This way! Oh no, it burns through my rope. You get horribly burned. Then your rope snaps. Then you fall on the spears.
You are charred. You are barbecued.
You find that this is a dead end. You cannot
quite literally
passages or traps. It just seems like a dead end. How pointless.
No, I don't believe it.
I'm supposed to be the suspicious one.
Why just put a dead end when every other hallway has landed in trap?
Well, do you want me to look more thorough? I look more thorough. I spend time looking more thorough.
Maybe they ran out of spears. But there is no trap here.
There's nothing here.
What about the secret wall?
Are there any different runes than what we've seen?
No.
Your ancestors suck.
This place is bullshit.
It is the stuff that comes out the backside of your elk.
No, that elk shit.
Well, he is a bull.
Does this one go north any?
Oh, yes.
It's the oh, yes.
Of course it does. Yeah.
You ask silly questions.
Silly questions for such silly people.
Bernard's little legs are tired. I'm going to stay here. You come back for me if you find anything that isn't trap.
Watch him run fast if we say, gold, gold!
No, what did you say?
it just appeared out of the wall.
Gold? What are we talking about now?
Somebody say gold.
And after a lot of walking, a lot of looking...
Backtracking.
Find something that isn't a dead end or a dead end with a trap.
Monster.
Instead, you find a large room with four statues, each in every corner of the room. And they seem to be holding up the ceiling. And in the middle of the room is a huge anvil on a raised floor. And the anvil is covered with runes and snakes that wind around the foot of the anvil.
It's the anvil of nope. No other exits from this room?
Not that you can find, no.
One hallway dead ended right behind it. That's...
Hey, Bernard!
And do you want separate trap checkies for this area?
There does not seem to be any traps. A lot of tools, though. This is probably a smithy.
I would agree with that, but there's no source of fire.
Oh, I wouldn't say that. It's probably somewhere.
See, the anvil is magic. Has lots of runes on it.
Alright, don't touch anything.
Yeah, I search know. The room. Thank you. I'm one who's making this roll when we come inside. Do the runes on the anvil say anything, or...?
Well, as you take a close look at them...
Welcome to the death room, suckers. Squishes us.
Just this is where the statues let go of the ceiling, suckers.
GPK!
Since you are familiar with the forces of magic, you know that these runes carries magic themselves. They do not specifically say anything, mm-hmm. but they are making the forge enchanted.
I suppose it'd be read magic to... Or I suppose I could make an arcana check to see exactly what it is these runes do or what they pertain to. It's only a 13.
It has something to do with heat.
Oh, the anvil gets hot.
Bane says, gold it!
Hey Bane, why don't you touch it?
What? Why?
Experiment, just to see, you know.
Oh, what'd you see?
Don't touch it, you fool.
Well, I would have done it.
I know you would have. That's what makes us not so much funny.
What?
Does anybody have any unpopped popcorn?
No, you didn't let us buy any at last port. You said, no, waste of money.
Well, it was 3 coppers a pound.
I was willing to pay gold. Gold's worth. Much. Lots of it.
Okay. Well, I'm not really in the mood to forge anything right now. This seems like a very elaborate and expensive piece of equipment to put in a home of a dead man.
Maybe there's a ghost. Bane is only half kidding. Kind of looks around himself.
So... Do the tools in here look like they've been moved or disturbed, or are they all just sort of sitting in their racks?
They seem to be sitting in their place. They have been used at mm-hmm. some point.
But they've been sitting here long enough to gather dust.
Oh, yes.
All right.
I hold my hand over the anvil, but I'm not touching it. Any heat, anything like that?
No.
I touched the tip of my spearhead to it. A metal spearhead.
The anvil suddenly burst into a glowing, hot temperature.
That's what Jeez. I thought.
That is pretty cool. I'm just going to say, that is pretty cool.
When you touch it with metal.
Oh, so see, it wouldn't have burned me anyway, he says, putting his hand on it.
And it does not, in fact, heat up.
See? Bane wins again!
Can I touch my spear back to it again while he's still got his hand on it? Like.
Ah!
All right, what else is down here?
Look at Bernard. Maybe I should retire as your scout and let him take the job.
Yeah.
She's much more eager to test out things. There's nothing in here for us.
Any of the tools special or anything like that?
Well,
they are well made and maintained, but other than that, there are ordinary tools.
I don't want to spend the next hour carrying, 300 pounds of tongs.
High quality tongs. Tongs over. That only your mother could tell you about.
What about these two up here?
Which ones?
There's what? Two up here.
Oh, was there? Oh yeah, there was.
Yeah.
Joink.
More pathways.
It's like some convoluted dwarf built this.
Bernard, you had nothing to do with this, right?
Not to my knowledge, no.
Why are you exploring a different tunnel than me?
Because now there's no traps here. The statues lied to us.
The statues lied to us?
So, when I notice my employer is not following me, my way back, where did he go? Bernard!
Bane is just standing in the middle like, who am I supposed to go with? Where is my babysitter? I need an adult!
Your short dwarven ass back here.
I tell you right now, it is at end of this hallway you are in. It is going back and forth many times, and then there is staircase, and then there is hole in ground.
You know what? I don't tell you how to sell things.
That's my job.
That's Bane's job.
I'm a business consultant.
I'm just going to move the one token around. These guys can stay put. Mm-hmm. At least as far as clicking and dragging everything until we find something interesting. Yeah, I can. It's the never-ending dwarven tunnels.
Yeah, one of these hallways is going to, I don't know, drop a golem on you.
Of course. There's always that hallway that drops a golem on you.
Amen. I didn't know there was going to be a maze this time, so it'll be interesting when you see mine.
There's a door.
There's a triangle! Oh.
That's a door, not the triangle. Listen at the door. Smell it.
Well,
it's... Have Bane taste it.
There's no sound, and there's not much smell either.
I get paid extra to taste things. He's in contract.
Is it locked? Is it trapped?
It does not appear either locked or trapped.
Is there a space underneath it?
Not that you could push anything through.
Okay. Then I get in my kit, and I use the little drill found with him, and I drill a hole through... Wait, what is the door made out of?
Stone.
Scratch that, I don't drill through the door.
guys, just wait a minute. You're just gonna do my thing
here. Give me a second here. Bane, take over. This is tiresome.
Yeah, next week.
Okay, crack it open a little bit, enough to slip my mirror in.
It's a room.
A room?
It's a room with three piles of stone.
Great, it's the supplies of coal.
Alright, rocks. I know rocks. Let the rock guy look at it.
Why are you so pushy?
Would you want to look at rocks?
It's part of his job. He is employer. He told me that's what they do.
Alright, open the door the rest of the way and then look inside for traps before I let this numbskull in.
There seems to be three piles of rocks. And that's it.
Yay, glory be, we are rich with rocks. Is that all that's in this room? There's no ways out?
There are only three piles of rock.
Search the room. Search the piles.
I want to do appraisals on the rocks. Are they just rocks? Are they special types of rocks?
Well, they have probably been carefully selected because they are rounded in shape and very nice to hold.
Why'd they want fancy little rocks for holding?
Wait. Are they set up in like an oval pattern or are they just a random pile?
Well, they seem to be more in an oval pattern.
Yes, you might want to leave those alone.
Yeah, stacked like over a body.
There are any markings that say that this might be, you know, so-and-so buried here or something?
No markings.
Well, Bernard, I don't feel like digging up the honored dead.
Yeah, no, I'm good.
Moving on. Hey, guess what's up here?
There it is.
Is this our trap?
Well, it is a dead end, but it does not seem to have a trap.
Are you sure there's no trap? There's been lots of traps. Are you sure there's no trap?
Hey, there's nothing at the end of this hallway. I say we go back. This place is deliberately maddening.
We've got to find the other clues to get out, right? Forest keeps leading us places.
It is getting a bit uncomfortable walking around these halls with the only sound is your echoing footsteps.
Bernard, I am spookified. Sing me something.
That's not entirely true. Bernard has been singing Diggy Diggy Hole the entire way.
Bernard, change your tune. We need new
song. So, no trap here?
No trap.
Just dead end.
Just dead end.
Spend more time searching it, because, yeah.
I don't know what your guys' problem is. It's kind of homey in here.
Bernard, where do you go?
That produces nothing.
Wander off again.
Back.
Bernard, do not go wandering off. You die, we don't get paid.
That's why I stopped here.
We sell his stuff, we get paid.
Oh, that's true. I'm no good salesman, though. No one buys from me.
Yes, I sell it in bulk. I sell it in bulk, offload it on somebody, we sell the elk for venison.
No. We don't have to sell elk. He's good, you know? Good guy. Like the elk.
Pretty sure that elk could kill one of you anyways.
He will be devastated by poor Bernard dying. We're over here talking about our employer's death while he's right behind us.
Yeah. I get the feeling this is not the first time.
It's this damnable place. What are your people thinking when they do this kind of crap?
That they would confuse and eventually kill grave robbers.
Yes, well, we're not grave robbers and we're far stupider, apparently, because we keep wandering around this place.
Maybe they just like to dig.
They just like to dig. That's the reason. That's the only reason.
Is there a trap?
There is no trap here.
Are you sure there's no trap? Yeah, he's going to start asking that at every every time we come to a end of a corridor.
Well, it's a stairway with a dead end, which has at least a 50% chance of having a trap, apparently.
But you haven't checked the wall, though.
Could You're be killing me.
Could be a secret passage.
I thought I was doing in general searchage. Do I need to go back and roll specifically for each of these quote unquote dead ends?
No.
It's just fucking me.
You sneaky bastard. You fucking nice holy. Look, a door.
It is a door.
It's a door. People?
Any traps on the door?
No.
Stone door.
It's going to have rocks. It's going to have rocks.
It's a store dome.
Store dome?
Stone door. It's a hoe door, okay?
It's a hobo. It's a hobo door. It won't murder us if we go to sleep.
A murder hobo door. That should totally be an enemy.
They are. They call them mimics.
I was just going to say that.
No. I mean something like specific. There's murderous
yes,
doors.
Yes, they're mimics.
No. Mimics can be anything. These things are specifically doors.
Oh, it's like a
yeah, they're called doors with traps. Ooh, there's lots of doors here.
More doors.
More door?
More door.
Oh, uh-oh.
You can't just simply walk into those.
No, you need to open them first.
You know, if I was a seasoned D&D player, this might get a little frustrating. I stop and hit each one and look down. You're fucking with me, Alex. Fucking I'm gonna go murder hobo on you in like 10 seconds.
Oh. Are you now?
He's like, I've successfully got them to the point. To the point of breaking.
The brink of madness.
They're just all connected. They were strip mining here for some reason.
I actually made a maze for Rogue Trader. It took me like 5 hours. It was a big maze.
I believe it.
Alright, listen at each of the doors. Check each of the doors for traps.
No doors have traps. They're all made of stone.
Open.
Why do we even have you around? Not even any traps. Where's the excitement?
By all means, you go ahead wander around. Maybe you come into one of those dead ends. Maybe
okay. He pushes this door open.
Maybe there's not a pit trap. Maybe there is.
Door slides open.
See? No trap. He just...
Now walk to the end of that hallway.
This one?
That one.
The rightmost.
Yeah.
Same deal. Oh my god. This one.
Now, this one actually leads to a room, which is rare, it seems. And in this room, there are, on the walls, just covered with weapons and shields.
Ooh. Hey.
They are finely crafted and well maintained.
Which one? Oh, the leftmost one? Or the rightmost?
Yep.
I gotcha.
Have these weapons also been sitting long enough to gather dust?
They have.
Like a substantial amount of dust, or?
How much dust are we talking? Are we talking like an inch of dust? Are
like
we talking
all the dust?
Like a little dust?
I mean, like, are we talking like these have been here for a week, or like, am I gonna, like, if I wipe my hand across one, it's just gonna come back like caked?
I mean, these weapons have probably been here for a good while. Years.
Are they worth anything, and do we dare take them?
Appraise! Are these normal weapons or masterwork weapons? 7, 15.
They are probably made for ceremonial use, because they are better looking than actually usable. You could definitely kill someone with them, but they're not as good as a good old iron axe or a steel sword.
They jeweled, all that fun crap.
They don't really have jewels, but they have finer ornaments, or like silver and a bit of gold here and there.
I am sure they are worth something if we take them. The problem is this is still supposedly a cairn.
Very, very bad to remove weapons from a cairn.
The vast majority of weapons are axes, but there are swords and daggers and spears too.
Is there anything really special that actually looks like it's more than just ornamental?
No.
This is a terrible dungeon. There's loot, but if I'm too, I don't want to take any of it.
Okay, last door on the left.
Last door on the left.
Hey, look! There's more friends.
No, but these ones are like...
That one looks disturbed.
Well, this room is filled with skulls. More specifically, troll skulls. You can clearly see that they are not as finely shaped as a human skull would be.
Ah, they are the skulls of his enemies, yes?
Trophies, looks like.
Look around the corner.
More skulls.
Just skulls, no other parts of skeletons?
Just skulls.
Poke around through them.
There are bigger skulls and smaller skulls, but they all seem to be from the trollkin, as far as you can tell.
This guy really did not like trolls.
No.
Can't imagine why.
Well, it is probably because the dwarves, you know, they don't... Oh. Oh, yeah.
Your ancestors dug a lot of freaking holes. A lot of freaking holes. And filled it up with dead trolls.
Oh, I like that one.
Okay, down this random hallway down here.
Just gonna have to do this.
Go back!
Wah,
wah. Wah, wah, wah.
Are you my troll dog?
As you step over here, the whole floor collapses and sinks into the walls to reveal two huge mangles that are immediately set in motion.
Mangles?
Mangles.
Like a
mangano? Like a great big ass crossbow?
Big wheels.
Oh,
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, picture like, you know, like an old laundry wringer.
Where are they coming from?
Well, all this entire area falls down and reveals the mangles. So I would have
to make
a reflex save.
The rollers in the floor. Okay, I got you.
Yeah. Gonna turn you into pizza dough.
Reflex save for me. That's a 20.
All right. As the fall drops, you manage to land on top of one of the mangles and not.
Oh shit! That's awesome.
Add a turn order here, just for ease.
Okay.
That's a 20.
Yeah, you don't have to roll initiative just to keep track on everyone's actions.
Okay.
So did he fall into the pizza stretcher?
He fell into the pit, landed on top of one of the mangles and not in the middle, so he's not crushed
yet.
But he is on top of a moving mangle.
All right. So what I would like to do is an acrobatics check to kick off from one of the walls and get onto the solid ground.
All right.
Come on, Dysage. Does a 24 work?
You manage to get a hand on the edge of the floor.
Hey, pull me up.
I am going to. I'm coming. Why did you do that? Why did you say what was up?
Less talking, more pulling.
You know, if you die, it makes me sad, right? You know, I just joke around about the whole selling your stuff, right?
Stop crying when you are pulling. Just pull.
All right. You can make a strength check to try and get him up.
I will aid. Or attempt to. Or no, I'll just touch you.
I'm just going to touch him. Hey, plus two. Good.
Pets his butt, like, get to it.
You're doing good.
Great. I believe in you.
Just tapping him on the back. You pushed too hard. He falls down.
Fall on top of Joel. Fall on top of Aiden, and then he's like.
Well, that's all for them. I guess I'll go find the Fountain of Youth on my own, and then he dies in a horrible trap on the way back out.
I wonder if that troll will come in.
Wonder if I could buy that troll.
So, are you guys going to pull me out, or are you just going to sit here?
Yeah. Well, he's got to make his strength check.
I've got to make my strength check, which is going to be 8 plus...
2?
No, 3.
You manage to get a hold of him, but you just can't really jank him up.
So wait, you got plus 2 from me. Kane.
Oh, plus 5 then.
Yeah.
It was.
So 13.
Yeah.
You get a good grip of him, but you can't really get his body up.
No.
He's starting to hiccup. No, don't you die, because that doesn't be fair. We're supposed to drink.
And a cobblestone falls down and just
obliterates between the mangles.
Hold on. Is it back up to me?
Yep.
I'm going to use his hold on me to do a, I guess it'd be a kip up.
And you managed to get up.
I'm thinking that would have hurt a whole lot.
Would probably be over swiftly.
Don't you do that again. You pay more attention, he says, thumping you. You pay more attention.
It's all right. I am okay. I might have pissed a little, but I am okay.
Okay.
Alright, I am going to take my time carefully searching this area to see if there's a way to stop this thing.
Well, there are no... you don't find any ways that you could stop these from rolling. And there are no footholds along the walls.
Well, at least we know we are on the right track, right?
How much do you guys like mountaineering?
Mountaineering?
Nah, I'm not a huge fan of it.
What? You're the dwarf!
I would rather dig around the trap than suspend myself over it.
Alright, so I pound a python into the wall.
All right. Destroying the fine works of the dwarves.
Yep.
Fix it later.
Is there any handholds or anything for a difficult climb check?
I mean, you could possibly grab hold of the runes and the walls, but they are very fine and intricate. They're not very reliable.
How long is this thing?
25 feet.
Holy shit. Run around and judge about where it's at and search this hall to see if there's any way to bypass.
There does not seem to be any way to shut it down or any secret ways or anything like that.
Sure would be nice to have Mick Diggerson's shovel.
Okay, so I just dropped my guy behind yours. So I go about this the long way with using rope and python to create a bridge of sorts.
All right.
Which I imagine that takes a fair amount of time.
Indeed.
Tink, 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 tink.
So do I eventually get to the other side doing this crap? I keep myself tied off instead of, you know, trying to be all Indiana Jones about it.
Gotcha. Well, in due time, you make it to the other side.
Alright, fix the rope to one of the other pythons over there and we will make a way to cross a bridge of sorts.
Okay. Tie.
And through the magic of time.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
Unless you want people to do checks for this.
Well, even if you fail, you would just be caught by the rope.
Pretty much.
It's not that much of a difficult climb either. It is very scary to look down, knowing that you will be crushed to death immediately.
way to soften the... Jesus.
This immortality better be worth it. I don't want any catches. You know, like...
See what it did to that cobblestone? Alright, does anybody else have any rope?
Yes, I have about 50 feet.
Yes, tie it around my waist, would you?
Oh, no, okay, so we're going to be careful, huh? Tie. I am not tying it to me. I am holding on to it, but I am not tying it to me.
Yes, thanks for that. So, onward.
And you reach a room.
Yeah, the only thing I could think of is something in Earth Elemental to ferry us across.
When you step into the room, eager flames burst up from big oil bowls hanging from the ceiling. They cast long and nasty shadows on a large heap of stones. A shiny shield made out of the finest metal is symbolically hanging on the wall behind the stone pile. Each stone seems to have been carefully chosen and has a surface smoother than the paths that you have walked through. Upon the shield is a runic text in silver. Here lies Runwid Coldhammer, by us called Runkotta Caxibol, by the shield protected.
Can you type that one down again?
To Bernard, that's a pretty looking shield, but that, you know, it's probably cursed, so we can't have it, but it sure looks nice, you know?
Runes with Coldhammer. I don't know if that's a secret.
Is the secret that he's dead?
Yeah, but I'm gonna write it down.
Rubik Coldhammer is dead.
I rush up to the shield, absorb the power, and then go foos. Does the cairn pop open? Raggedy ass dwarf. So his name was Runvid Coldhammer, the Rune Cutter?
Well, the last part, we're not sure about.
Anything special about the shield?
Well, it is very finely made. Made out of some very nice mineral. And it seems to be molded into the rock wall. As you look closer at the shield, there is a rune engraved in the middle of it.
And what does it say? Mean?
It says freedom.
Freedom! Oh.
Hey, what's the dwarven word for freedom?
Bello.
I say we touch it.
Touch it?
The shield?
Yeah.
It is...
Are you going to touch it?
I'll touch it.
It's smooth. A bit cold. But it feels nice.
Nothing happens.
No, nothing happens.
What if I say the dwarven word for freedom?
Nothing happens.
I give up. I desecrate the tomb and doom us all.
The lure of the weapons and armor is too much for him to bear. Well, this was exciting.
I know, you almost died.
Hopefully we got what we were looking for.
And these are the only words and the only scripture that we could read.
Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom. Boom, boom.
All right. Boom, boom. Let's get the hell out of here.
When the night... No, okay, yeah, that's... fuck this place.
We all... Bane looks at Bernard and says, no, we've talked about that.
So you leave without desecrating the tomb?
Yes, I believe that is... That's what's going to happen.
He's a bad mojo.
Not to desecrate the tomb.
Well, see, Bane is torn.
Not everybody is looting, pillaging, murdering hobos.
Yeah.
Not everyone. But most.
I say disturbing a tomb is a bad idea.
But we disturbed the dragon.
Yes, but the dragon wasn't in, like, a huge crypt. It was just dead in a cave.
Oh, so dragon lives are not as important as dwarven lives, huh?
Hey, if we
no,
find
they're
dead,
not.
If we find the dead dragon in a huge mausoleum that we spent 3 hours walking around, I won't touch it either.
Damn it.
I don't
should have
collected
a dragon soul by now. We obviously came to a frickin' burial chamber with some crazy scripture written on a shield. I should be able to do a dragon shout.
Definitely.
No, no.
If we don't,
once we're all back across, I collect bits and bobs because I don't have tons of that stuff with me. So rope and pipes.
All right. Well, as you leave the hall, you see that the flame fades and it becomes dark behind you again.
If we don't find, like, the third secret, or if we don't find some secrets by in some goddamn answers by the next game, I'm just gonna go back and kick that troll's ass.
We're gonna go back, we're gonna try and find that place again. And we'll spend the whole campaign trying to find that place again just to beat the snot out of that one half-troll in a cave at the very beginning, like third session, that didn't have anything to do with anything. We just kind of ended up there.
to leave Wildheart and, like, save a kingdom. Bane will marry a princess. All the
No. Bane will become a prince and make Asta his princess. Oh, there we go. Lord.
Copy. You're a slumlord with a prostitute. Fantastic.
That's a movie right there.
And I'll be dead, crushed by some horrible freaking trap.
That's okay. I'll be an incredibly powerful cleric by then. I'll just bring you back to life.
We'll use resurrection, but you'll come back like a yeah.
Fucking zombie. I'm
just like a mush. There, you can be my employee forever and ever.
I don't want to be a Drakar anymore. I want to be a real boy. Oh.
He's gonna let me see. What was it? No.
So how much time do we spend there?
It's really hard to tell, but if you leave the cairn without doing anything, yes? Then
I can't think of what we would do.
I'm just asking.
Yeah,
there has to be something we should do.
Like I said, we don't all have to be murdering, grave robbing hobos.
We don't, but I feel like there was no conflict resolution here.
We just explored for where?
It was like the plot of the second Grown Ups movie. There was nothing happening.
Well, the only thing of real significance in there was the shield with the writing on it. We got the writing off of that, so I think we got the piece that we needed.
Well, as you exit, there is complete darkness outside. You must have been in there for hours.
Oh, we might as well set up camp then.
Are we going to move again, middle of night?
Not if we camp in the doorway.
Yeah, but then my dragon bones might go somewhere.
I don't care about your damnable dragon bones.
I care about the dragon bones.
I sleep in the wagon.
Aodin sleeps in the doorway, and he's not there in the morning, and we're like, oh, where is he? What happened?
And then he comes back with breakfast.
We're all like, he's dead, they took him, the zombies got him in the middle of the night, we're all going to die.
Yeah. So, are we ending on making camp?
Seems like a good spot. Mm-hmm.
You take turns guarding, I assume, as you have done previous nights.
No crazy druids.
Not that you see or hear.
Yeah, we keep an extra swift eye out for those crazy druids.
Damn crazy druids.
The forest is not completely silent. You hear something out there.
Yay, something.
Caw, caw, caw.
Rawr. Caw, caw, caw.
Faint sounds of animals, presumably.
I set out some bear traps for breakfast.
Bear for breakfast.
You can roll a survival check.
22.
Alright, well, you place your traps.
I got snares too.
And you all fall asleep, and we'll pick this up next time. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.